Look over here. Right. Look over here. See if the camera can pick this guy up.
Right.
Oh, Enid's coming out to throw us off the set.
Okay, let's just see about that.
Bobby Heenan making his way to the broadcast booth.
A little something from
come on, Bobby.
A little something from the Arnold Palmer collection.
You want to do what?
I want to talk business.
Hey, grab a microphone if you want to talk.
Talk business. What are you doing here?
You want to talk? Grab a microphone so they can hear you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Eddie Arnold.
You going to throw us off the set, Bobby?
I want to talk business. I want to talk business to you. Now, Mr. Bischoff, I've admired you since the day I came to work here. The reason I left the World Wrestling Federation was because of you. I wanted to work for a man like you with your initiative and your brains. I mean, you're the Donald Trump of wrestling. You make Steven Spielberg look like a guy running 8mm films in a garage someplace. I can see the NWO, the direction they're taking right now. I've always been with a winner. I've always been a winner. I've got to be with Nitro. I've got to be with NWO Nitro because you guys are the winners right now. I can see that right now. And this means more to me than anything. This means more to me than wrestling, more than managing. This is my broadcasting career. And I can see the direction you're going in now. You're number one. I got to be a part of that. I got to be a part of being number one. That's just the way I am. And I'm asking you, could you consider me for this job? I mean, I can't live up to the expectations that you have of people because you're so far above
everybody. Shut up, will you? Yeah.
Thank you.
Giving me a headache. Kevin, you got to take a break, right? I mean, you had a couple bottles.
And you're the biggest guy I know in this sport.
Is he the giant?
He's the giant. He's a giant.
You're in.
You know, anybody.
You're the guy that's like a jockey at the Kentucky Derby. You're the giant. And you, we go back a long way. I don't think I ever managed anybody with more desire and a better competitor than you.
And let me ask you this, Bobby Heenan. Does Sting not deserve to have his neck broken by Hulk Hogan?
Yes.
Very good.
Anybody that's done what that man has done to Hulk Hogan deserves it.
Bobby.
Now, Hogan and I haven't always been agreeing on things, but you know, under misunderstandings, we can settle.
Bobby!
Bobby, you can take my chair. I'm going to go in the back and
sit down,
on a horse or something.
Sit down, will you? Yeah. Don't hug me. Just sit down and put the headset on and let's see what you're made out of.
Is that what you call kissing up here?
No, that's what you call a gold medal in kissing up. If it was an Olympic sport, this guy would be on a box of Wheaties.
Boy, does this feel different sitting here. This feels great.
Fans, we are back with you live on WCW Monday Nitro. And we are beginning our second hour of what has been a very exciting program. It's going to be, Mike Tenay, a two-man broadcast team because of the actions. What do you want?
What do you mean, what do I want?
What are you doing here? I mean, after last week, it's very apparent to Mike Tenay, to me, to the world, whose side you're on, the loser's side.
No, you don't understand something. While you sat out here and you sat out here and everybody sat out here and they dimmed the lights, they tore down the set, they beat up people, they used ball bats, they did whatever they wanted to, no one did anything. I'm the only one, I'm talking to you, I'm the only one that bit the bullet. I'm the one that ran into the fiery house and rescued the cats. Somebody had to take charge here. You didn't help me, nobody helped me. So I did this for WCW.
Hold on, you're trying to say you did this for all of us? You, for the first time in your life, you didn't do something for your own hide?
No, I went into their pit. I went into their fiery den. I sacrificed myself for WCW and the tradition of professional wrestling. And all I expect is to be greeted with open arms.
You mean tonight?
Thank you, Tony. Good idea.
Holy Moses.
You gotta be kidding.
You are the weasel. You just walk back in here. Now you're a part of WCW.
Thank you. Roll it.
You have no idea where we're going, do you?
Doesn't matter. I'm back on Nitro.
You're back on Nitro.
And I'm back home. They say you can't go home. I've come back home. I'm home again. And it feels good to be home.
He's a front runner.
Boy, you are. So you're going to join us for the second hour?
Yes.
Had the NWO prevailed last night, whose side would you have been on? Would you have been out here with Bischoff and Rude?
Tony, I'd have been with you. I'd have been with WCW. I did what I had to do for the people here at WCW.
All right. The weasel's back. You're too much. This is the same old weasel back at his own annex. And you just plopped yourself down here.
Catchy tune, huh?
Oh, fans.
expect this.
Of course, he showed his true colors last week.
I have never, can I say this publicly? I have never seen a person grovel as much as you did last week. You were sickening.
You don't know my uncle.
And so this was all a major plan.
It was a plan. It was a plan of mine. No one else took charge. I had to take charge.
Absolute front runner.